It's the late 1990s, and Andrew Fire and Craig Mello are contemplating the control of genes through RNA molecules. The current theory around the topic is extremely vague and states that upon the injection of antisense RNA into organisms, the sequence binds to a complementary mRNA strand and silences its expression. Fire and Mello see that the current theory is incomplete and set out to examine some unanswered questions regarding this largely unknown mechanism. The two major features in previous studies that seem to trouble Fire and Mello most were the seeming ability of both sense and antisense RNA strands to individually induce interference, and the fact that these interferences seem to perpetuate onto the progeny of the affected organism. Fire and Mello insisted that this refuted the current theory and speculated that another mechanism was at play. They termed this unknown mechanism RNA interference, or RNAi for short. Early on, Fire and Mello deduced that the normal use of bacteriophage RNA polymerases in the preparation of RNA populations created some structures that had double-stranded rather than a single-stranded appearance. They inferred that the hybridisation of complementary antisense and sense RNA formed these double-stranded RNA molecules, and that these molecules might have a role to play in RNA interference. To test this, Fire and Mello used a gene called UNC22, which when knocked out produces a twitching phenotype. By using a DNA template of UNC22 gene region and bacteriophage RNA polymerases, they produced single-stranded sense and antisense RNAs. After being purified, these RNA strands were then individually injected into C. elegans organisms, while other C. elegans organisms were injected with RNA populations deliberately prepared to contain double-stranded RNAs. To their surprise, Fire and Mello saw that the progeny of C. elegans organisms injected with purified antisense and sense RNAs saw a wild-type phenotype, whereas the progeny of animals injected with double-stranded RNA saw a twitching phenotype. This indicated that single-strand injections were susceptible to degradation and could not induce interference in the absence of its opposite strand. Additionally, Fire and Mello discovered that the site of injection had minimal effect on the animal's phenotype, with injections of double-stranded RNA into the gonads, tail, and head showing similar interference with the organism. This shows the surprising ability of double-stranded RNA to cross cellular boundaries, which provided a viable explanation to the robustness of RNA interference across generations. Upon confirming their findings on other genes such as UNC54, they also discovered that injected double-stranded RNAs that were complementary to target mRNA intron or promoter regions produced wild-type phenotypes. When these double-stranded RNAs were targeted to exon regions, however, silencing was induced. From this, they speculated that RNA interference likely only occurs on post-transcriptional mature mRNA strands rather than on nucleic pre-mRNA. To observe RNA interference on a more cellular level, Fire and Mello injected C. elegans embryos with a stain targeting an endogenous MEX3 mRNA. They then injected both purified MEX3 sense, antisense, and double-stranded RNA. They discovered the embryos that were injected with single-stranded RNA showed substantial retention of MEX3 mRNA, while the embryos injected with double-stranded RNA showed no sign of the MEX3. This indicated that the RNA interference silenced genes through the degradation of its respective mRNA transcripts. Despite no clear mechanism for RNA interference being described, Fire and Mello received the Nobel Prize for their advancement of the field, as their accomplishments sequentially paved the way for many more discoveries on the topic. The current mechanism underlying RNA interference states that the exogenous double-stranded RNA binds to a protein complex called dicer, which liberates the antisense strand from its annealed state and cleaves it into small fragments called small interfering RNA. This antisense strand then binds another protein complex called RNA-induced silencing complex, or RISC. This antisense strand then guides this complex to degrade its complementary mRNA strand and silence its expression. Endogenously occurring double-stranded RNA is expressed in the hairpin-like structure called pre-microRNA in the cell nucleus. When introduced to the cytoplasm, this molecule binds to the dicer complex and then undergoes a similar process to that of the exogenous pathway. Organisms such as the C. elegans utilize these double-stranded RNAs to protect them against virally introduced RNA or to inhibit the synthesis of unwanted proteins. When used in an exogenous manner, RNA interference has proven to be an extremely valuable research tool, as it allows researchers to introduce an unknown RNA sequence into an organism and observe its function according to the genes it silences and the resulting phenotype. It also opens up exciting opportunities in the treatment of diseases by silencing the expression of harmful proteins via double-stranded RNAs. Therapies currently in clinical trials include the treatment of neurological diseases such as Huntington's and Alzheimer's disease, cardiovascular diseases, diseases of the liver such as hepatitis B and C, multiple types of cancers such as lung cancer, and endocrine diseases such as chronic renal disease.